With right.
Right. But Puerto Rico owes, what, $75 billion right now?
72, yeah.
72. I don't see statehood, I don't see Congress or Senate ever.
Me neither.
Ever
Me neither.
Taking on a $72 billion debt
exactly.
load. Especially for a lot of people who speak Spanish.
Exactly.
What's the way out of this?
Oh, my God.
What about tourism?
It's an industry of services to service
exactly.
the wealthy. And then at the same time, you take $450 million out of the university, for example. So you're going to have less educated people willing to do any type of work.
To survive. Yeah. You are not really producing an economy that a person can survive on, you know?
Right.
This is a country where people live, where we do things, and we have culture and literature and music and produce intellectual important work. They are selling us as only a good resort to have a piña colada in the beach, and
no,
that's
it. Piña coladas.
We actually invented piña colada,
yeah,
so
I'm
I shouldn't be talking about piña colada.
Even though we are like getting over by
vultures.
Yeah, a lot of vultures. The people of Puerto Rico are good people, and I think that we're gonna get past this.
In the early 70s, things were looking pretty good for Puerto Rico. A tax incentive was introduced which helped lure dozens of major companies to the island, employing significant numbers of people. But when that incentive expired in 2006, concurrent with a major recession in the States, those companies packed up and left. So along came the municipal bond. A big, fat IOU that appeared to be salvation for a near-broke government. They're sexy for investors, triple exempt from taxes, and bond owners buying Puerto Rican debt would have to be paid back before anyone. That's anyone. Hedge funds, or vulture funds as they are often referred to in these cases, had profited from similarly desperate situations in Greece, Argentina, and Detroit. As the situation worsened for Puerto Rico, you could buy up more and more bonds for pennies on the dollar. This was a fire sale too sweet to pass up.